Drew, talk to us about the significance of this, kids ages 5 to 11.
This is pretty meaningful. I mean, I think this has been a group that has a, you know, for parents certainly, sending them back to school, thinking about childcare challenges, you know, a lot of the things that have been most disruptive to, you know, a pretty large, sizable and important part of the workforce. You know, this is a significant step along the way to seeing this vaccine cleared for use in this population. More to go. Obviously, the FDA has to, you know, sign off as well, and then it goes before the CDC's own expert panel to kind of finalize and craft the recommendations on exactly how this vaccine should be used and how widely. But, you know, when you're talking about a 17-0 vote, that's a pretty strong signal in favor.
What about the, we've been talking about the size of shot, to use a non-technical phrase, but sort of the strength. Could you see smaller dosing for the younger audience? Particularly, they're sort of saying that might work on even the older kids too.
Yeah, I mean, you know, listen, the size of the dose and the intervals of these doses has been something that I think has been under discussion for quite a while now. Remember that the kind of original size and spacing of doses for pretty much all these vaccines was something we were determining, you know, last year in the most accelerated way possible. And so I think there's been an acknowledgement that that may not be ideal and that you might be able to, you know, space the Pfizer doses out, for example, slightly longer. You know, Moderna uses 4 weeks apart, Pfizer 3. There's been a lot of study on that. You know, and obviously kids are generally smaller than adults, so they're thinking that you don't need as much. And right now, you know, the dose they're talking about is about one-third the size of the dose size
Drew,
for people ages 12 and older.
How is this supposed to either help or perhaps complicate the discussion about what's going on in schools right now?
You know, I think if you have a vaccinated population in schools, it, you know, and parents can feel like they can trust that their kids have a degree of protection, it does a lot of the same things that it does for adults who are, you know, going to their workplace or going out to dinner or going on a trip. It basically says, okay, we know that there's still COVID out there. We know it's still possible for you to get COVID. We also know it's going to significantly, you know, reduce the risk of that disease. I think it changes the risk equation, you know, as it has for other populations that have been given access to vaccines. And it probably makes people a lot more comfortable with in-person schooling. It may significantly change how people think about the need for, you know, whether or not you're sending people home or closing down schools and all those types of things. It has significant potential to really change that and give people, parents as well, a lot more certainty.